Welcome to the Infowars Nightly News. It is May 22nd, 2012. I'm your host, Jon Bowne, and here is what we have for you tonight.
Tonight, the United States of China, America for sale. International bankers conjure up the plan to collapse both the American economy and the Chinese central bank in order to establish their long-awaited plans for a one-world currency and government. Then, a major development in the probe of Barack Obama's eligibility for the Arizona 2012 presidential ballot, as Sheriff Joe sends his cold case posse investigators to Honolulu in search of a valid birth certificate. Plus, the TSA goes undercover to interrogate bus riders. The voice of Resistance Radio and founding member of Houston Free Thinkers, Derrick Broze, joins us in studio to break down the TSA's latest partnership with the Metro Transit Authority in Houston, Texas. All that plus more of tonight's top stories up next on the InfoWars Nightly News.
All that and more on the InfoWars Nightly News, but let's begin with the first story about the Chinese, the United States of China, America for sale. The People's Bank of China is the Chinese central bank and has more financial assets than any other single public institution in the world ever. As a result of depreciation and diminishing American credit ratings, China has sought to hold other currencies and asset classes. The strain on Sino-American relations undoubtedly is the reason we are now hearing the bombshell news that the United States Treasury, for the first time in history, is directly selling government bonds to a foreign government. This means the Central Bank of China now has an exclusive purchasing arrangement not available to any other central bank in the world. The report disclosing this ultra-secret relationship suggests China now has a direct electronic computer link to the Treasury auction system. No public announcement was made and no warnings were given to primary Treasury dealers. No Federal Reserve cartel member or Treasury official is willing to comment on this due to its perversion of American sovereignty, which we're going to get into a lot more perversion of American sovereignty in the news coming up. But it's also resulting in a national security risk. Make no mistake, what is being conjured up here is the collapse of both the American economy and the Chinese central bank to ensure they both line up at the international banker trough and accept a brand new, shiny world government. Moving on to Arizona, where Arizona's Maricopa County Sheriff Joe Arpaio has dispatched his cold case posse investigators to Hawaii today. Arpaio is responding to the efforts of Arizona State Ken Bennett to acquire a legitimate copy of Obama's birth certificate from the Hawaii Department of Health. You may recall that in September of 2011, Sheriff Arpaio commissioned former Bergen County, New Jersey investigator Mike Zulo and a team of volunteers to investigate the authenticity of the birth certificate. Zulo announced in March that they had probable cause that the document is a forgery. Our own research at InfoWars immediately upon first inspection found that the document appears to be a photocopy taken from state records and printed on official green paper. However, when the government released PDF is taken into the image editing program Adobe Illustrator, we discover a number of separate elements that reveal the document is not a single scan on paper, as one might surmise. Elements are placed in layers or editing boxes over the scan and green textured paper, which is to say, at the very least, it's very unusual. When sections of the document are enlarged significantly, we discover glaring inconsistencies. For instance, it appears the date stamped on the document has been altered. Wherever the document contains text, numbers, and lines with suspicious white borders indicating these items were pasted from the original scan and dropped over a background image of green paper. And on Sunday's Alex Jones show, Alex spoke with Obama birth certificate investigator Jerome Corsi And Mr. Corsi is expecting bombshell developments on this in the coming week. Okay, so I'm working on this piece about Arpaio, and I hear this whiny British chatter on the television, and it's none other than Martin Bashir on his show bashing an American patriot just doing his job. I just don't get it. I don't get it. Why the English voice seems to have so much power over Americans, as if they're more sophisticated and they have a better understanding of our own republic. Let's go to that clip.
The state's other misanthrope, Sheriff Joe Arpaio, has decided to ignore authorities and dispatched his cold case posse direct to Hawaii. Now, aside from the fact that he's supposed to be a law enforcement official as opposed to a circus act, Sheriff Joe doesn't care about the criticism. It's one deputy. So what? Arpaio says, adding that the taxpayer expense will be reimbursed. But at least this deluded and deranged imbecile is asking the right question. So what indeed? Because while everybody already knows that the president is in fact an American, Ken Bennett and Sheriff Joe have achieved one remarkable feat.
Okay, I don't get it. So why is it that people from England can come to America and have gigantic television shows that put down us moronic, slobby Americans? And since you have an English voice telling us how bad we are at stuff, you know, you've got Simon Cowell.
I think you're not talented enough to be able to sing that song, but I have no talent at all.
And then you've got Piers Morgan.
I'm so completely aware of everything in America. I care so much about it. How come my ratings are so low?
And then you got this guy, Martin Bashir. Hey, says right here, Martin Bashir is a British journalist currently with NBC News. Bashir was born in Wandsworth, South London. Parents of Pakistani Christian origin and grew up in Wandsworth. Hey, Martin Bashir, how about you and Simon Cowell and Piers Morgan go back to England? Because we don't care. We're Americans. We don't care about your opinion about us. And we never will. That's why we kicked you out of our country in the first place.
While everybody already knows that the president is in fact an American.
And now in more news on our eroding sovereignty, according to the Daily Caller, former Senate Majority Leader Trent Lott claims he is not a hypocrite for lobbying in favor of a treaty he aggressively rejected in 2007. It appears the green glow of fees he has received from Shell Oil Company for his Bro Lott Leadership Group, founded in 2008 with former Louisiana Senator Jon Bowne, has opened his eyes to the benefit of total domination of American sovereignty by the UN. The treaty known as the United Nations Convention on the Law of the Sea, or the Law of the Sea Treaty, would, in the words of Lott from 5 years ago, cede our national sovereignty both militarily and economically. Basically, the treaty would transfer permit and royalty payments to the U.S. for offshore drilling to the International Seabed Authority. The International Seabed Authority would have the authority to redistribute this wealth to other nations, smaller, underdeveloped countries that the UN is going to use as a mask to steal the money and give it to their masters, the bankers, in many places, one of those being the City of London. The usual UN compromise figures are pushing hard for ratification. President Obama, Alaska's Senator Lisa Murkowski, and Arizona's Senator John McCain are chomping at the bit to impress their globalist masters. UN lackey and Defense Secretary of the United States, Leon Panetta, is breathing a sigh of relief after hearing about Trent Lott's admission of support for this treaty. The threat to national sovereignty, Lott alluded to in the past, refers to the treaty's power to cede all economic and military actions to an international consensus, making the U.S. Congress completely irrelevant. 26 Senate Republicans have signed a letter of opposition to the treaty, and we will keep you informed on developments in that. Moving on to the TSA news of corporations that just want to help with TSA gate rape. This from the LRC blog. Becky Akers writes that accordingly, Homeland Security Department contractors such as Adobe, Boeing Company, and IBM announced Monday the creation of the Washington Homeland Security Roundtable, TSA Senior Executive Industry Forum. They hope to start a dialogue with corporations to make it easier for the TSA to do their job. And she says in here that the director, Kay Olive, prattles, our objective is really to have industry have an opportunity to work with the leadership of the TSA. That's just what we need, more corporatized Homeland Stasi security. And we're going to talk to Derrick Broze about that coming up. In other TSA news, the TSA gropers are being trained to feel crotch bombs. That's right. Your crotch is now under Homeland Security protection. And, you know, I think we should all go get a crotch bomb check once a day, don't you? It makes sense. Our founding fathers created this nation, giving us all individual liberty and the right to the pursuit of happiness. And it only makes sense that I should go into a building and have my crotch submitted to being fondled and grabbed by a total stranger. No, that's what individual liberty and rights are. They are exactly the opposite of giving somebody the right in order to travel in a democratic republic to fondle my crotch or my wife's breasts or my child's genitalia. I mean, what? Are you awake? This is actually happening. You can go to the airport and get your crotch grabbed. Okay. You still in there? All right. Now, that brings me to, before we get to Derrick Broze, who's going to join us in the studio here in Austin, Texas, that brings me to the daily quote, which comes to us from Khalil Gibran, who had suffered his own oppression under the Ottoman Empire in Lebanon, and of course for his Syrian countrymen who were trying to express their own sovereignty. They were actually under a system that we're going under. Crotch grabbing to them was just par for the course. So from Khalil Gibran, life without liberty is like a body without spirit. And we will return after this brief message from our sponsors, which are us. And we will be joined by Derrick Broze. Thanks for joining us here at prisonplanet.tv. You can subscribe. There's a 15-day free trial. You can try this out at any time, an actual voice of liberty and sanity in this country, regardless of what you may have been told. We're not doling out conspiracy theories. We're not doling out yellow journalism, sans Martin, what is his name, Martin Bashir. We're here for you. We're here for ourselves. We're here for the right to have liberty and be American and be sane and not have our crotch grabbed. So we'll see you right after this.
Have you been to InfoWarsShop.com lately? Express your inner patriot with these brand new InfoWars t-shirts. Say it loud with the InfoWars bullhorn shirt. Or educate the sheeple with the Bill of Rights shirt. Grope the public's mind with the TSA shirt. And with this shirt, you can let the dark side know of the Rebel Alliance's power. All available at InfoWarsShop.com.
Alex Jones and crew are proud to announce the official launch of Planet InfoWars,
the largest activism social network in the world.
Get notified of the latest activity.
Planet Infowars features numerous groups spanning many diverse categories of interest, from guns and survival preparation to economics and politics.
It is an ideal forum for writers and journalists, both professional and activist.
Get in on the action today and join Alex's Planet Infowars community.
Sick of the globalist eugenicist control freaks adding poison to your water and laughing as you get sick and die? Start purifying your water with ProPure. My friends, I've done a lot of research, and the best gravity filter out there, bar none, is ProPure, and it's available discounted at Infowars.com. Its filters are silver impregnated to prevent bacterial growth. There's no priming required. It's NSF 42 certified. Optional fluoride filters can reduce fluoride up to 95%. Easy to set up and use. Doesn't require electricity. Purify water from lakes, streams, ponds, and wells. This filter system leaves in beneficial minerals, which is key. Save money by not buying bottled water and avoid BPA that leaches from the plastic. ProPure is the best gravity-fed filter out there. It's what my family uses. Infowars.com already has the lowest price on ProPure. But if you add the promo code WATER at checkout, you get an additional 10% off at Infowars.com. You can also call to order 888-253-3139.
But for metric rider Derrick Broze, it's not enough.
I don't feel like by purchasing a ticket or riding the bus that I have to forfeit my constitutional rights and my protections and be subject to search or seizure.
A friend of Broze's took these pictures of the bus safe exercise back on the 13th. He says they show TSA agents and Metro Police asking riders where they're going as they get off the bus and how often they ride that route.
Metro and TSA were going onto the buses and questioning people about their normal routes, their normal behaviors, and it just kind of creates an atmosphere of fear.
Okay, welcome back to the Infowars Nightly News. We are joined by Derrick Broze, the main character in the video you just saw, a character assassination attempt upon the TSA, you know, who are just trying to do us all a favor by keeping us safe and groping our crotches and groping other parts of our loved ones, all in the name of liberty and the republic and individual freedom. Derrick is a founding member of the Houston Freethinkers and a partner with We Are Change Houston. You also host a program on freedomizerradio.com, which is the voice of the resistance radio. And you co-host Freethinker Radio Local Live Houston Freethinker Radio at locallivehouston.com. Thanks for joining us, Derrick.
And
we're going
to
get into this lunacy. Just complete, I mean, how stupid do they think we are? How stupid are they to, well, let me read you this. A new program in Houston will place undercover TSA agents and police officers on buses whose job it will be to perform bag searches, watch for suspicious activity, and interrogate passengers in order to curb crime and terrorism. And then Democratic Congresswoman Sheila Jackson Lee unveiled the program labeled Bus Safe during a press conference on Friday, according to Metropolitan Transit Authority of Houston. The press release, agencies involved in the scheme will ride buses, perform random bag checks, and conduct canine sweeps, as well as place uniformed plainclothes officers at transit centers. And the video we're looking at right now is the response by the people for this program, and the response is amazing because the council denies everything, and yet they have a press release right here saying they're going to do all of these things. How bizarre was it to go down there and speak to people that have clearly lost their minds?
Hey, well, it was a little bit bizarre to be in that world. We've had two meetings so far with the Metro Board. The first one was pretty quickly after the incident happened. I think it was April 21st, Sheila Jackson Lee. She held a press conference at one of the transit stations in Houston, and a member of the Houston Freethinkers, Philip Levine, just happened to be at the right place at the right time. He got off the bus, started snapping pictures. He said he was questioned by them as well for why he was taking pictures, where he was coming and going from. He got a couple of pictures of TSA inspectors also questioning riders, you know, violating their rights, just coming and asking them what they're doing and apparently searching bags and getting on the buses as well. So I wrote an article, we put that out, and we chose to go to the Metro board meeting. You can sign up for public time to speak, and quite a few people decided to do that. Members of our group, We Are Change, the Harris County Criminal Lawyers Association. So we saw a lot of people stand up, not just for the Constitution, but stand up against the TSA and go there.
The place is packed, yeah, which it usually isn't.
I doubt they get 50 to 100 people in the news crew there for every Metro board meeting they do. You know, they don't really get that much attention. So when they realize that, one of the board members tried to put a halt on the meeting. He, you know, said, hey, even though we're part of the board and we're the head of this whole company, some of us have no idea this decision was made. So we see, you know, incompetence on their part with that. They tried to stop the meeting. We told them, no, you know, we're here to talk today. It got tense for a minute, but they let all of us speak. And in the video, you hear one of the heads of Metro saying that as long as he's there, there will be no bag searches. They said the press release was a mistake. So once we stood up and, you know, people of Houston decided to stand against this crotch grabbing by the TSA officers, they said, oh, it was a mistake. You know, that never was actually happened. We, even though the press release said it, and then a follow-up blog, which talked about the success of the program, also talked about bag searches. They said both of those were a mistake and that no bag searches happened, but
you realize where we're headed, people. We're talking about the same situation when you're dealing with a four-year-old child, and you know there's sugar and cookies all over the floor, and the refrigerator's open, and you come in there, and the kid's standing there, and it's clearly the kid, and the kid says, "He did it. I don't know who did it. I didn't do it. These are our leaders." These are our leaders. These are the people we voted into power. And it starts at a small level, and it just keeps on going. And so now we've got to deal with the TSA grabbing our crotches. They're getting more money from the Congress. Today that was announced. They're getting they're not getting taxpayer money. They're going to increase their the money they make at the airport. They're going to double it so that they can keep TSA right on chugging along. If we can go to that video, there's a part of that video, there are some pictures in there that show that the TSA, even though they denied that the TSA were not searching people's bags, and as far as we know, there aren't any witnesses to that. There are pictures, I think it's right around here, there you go. There's a TSA officer, and he's asking that guy what?
They were checking with the excuse that they later said was, and this is another lie from, if you want to look him up and contact him and ask him why he's lying, Chief Victor Rodriguez of Metro Police Department, he told us, and this picture proves he's lying, he told us at the second meeting that although there was Metro Police questioning people, he said essentially they were checking their bus cards, what they call cue cards, but those cards don't have any kind of identifying marks on them at all. So really, if I gave you my card, they wouldn't know the difference. So that was a false excuse as well. And he said it was only Metro Police Department, that there was no TSA. That picture shows otherwise, that the TSA was involved in getting on the buses and questioning people. So we caught them in numerous lies. We forced the media to cover it for that first meeting. The second meeting, which just happened last week, they unfortunately did not cover, but we're glad that you guys are staying on the story. The second time we went there, we basically forced them to say that the TSA would not be back in Houston unless a nationally significant event. That's as much as we could get so far, and they said a nationally significant event might be the Super Bowl or maybe a false flag event, who knows?
Yeah, and then there was a peculiar instance after they had left.
Yeah, that same day while we were at the
same
meeting.
Day.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, like literally as I'm getting out of the Metro board meeting, I'm getting text messages from people saying, did you see what just happened on the bus? And on another Metro bus somewhere else in the city, a passenger pulled out a gun, grabbed one of the other passengers, held him at gunpoint, made everybody else leave, and the police ended up coming on and shooting that man and killing him on the bus the same day, you know, that we're sitting there telling them there's no need for TSA. Another lie that Chief Victor Rodriguez said as well is he said the purpose of the TSA being there was based on sexual assaults. And you go back to the press release, and obviously we know what the TSA is there for. They're there for counterterrorism exercise. The bus safe program was a counterterrorism national pilot program. He said you know, when they went back and gave us a whole presentation on why they chose to use the TSA, and we have those pictures as well, he said it's based on sexual assaults that take place in these buses around town. 18, I think, last year, maybe 18 or 24, whatever it was, a lot of people were there to point out, we have HPD, Vice Crime Division,
city,
Sex Crime Division.
Right, you have
we have resources
squads.
For these
sure,
already, you know?
Of course you do.
We don't need to ask the TSA, the federal government, to come in there, and right. That's unfortunately the route that... Like you said, so much of little kids.
What's the solution, that the TSA would show up during a sexual assault and help?
They'd probably continue the sexual assault by groping everybody.
Yeah, you're not grabbing that crotch quite well enough. I mean,
that's it, we make jokes about it, but that's the reality of the situation, is that the TSA, the people who are there hired for the TSA.
I only make jokes to hide my incredible seething anger at the entire situation.
You know, this situation is something that does involve a lot of anger and a lot of frustration, and I'm happy to have been able to go up there and participate and to see so many people talking about constitutional rights, talking about how much it offended them that the country was going in this direction, and there was, you know, plenty of people from the Houston Freethinkers, but other just individual citizens out there who are like, you know, I can't let this happen. So my message to anybody listening is that if you see these things happening, we can put a stop to them. We can get involved by standing up, by going to these meetings. Like you said, it's just a Metro board meeting, but those 8 people right there are deciding what's going to happen for Houston. They're deciding whether or not we get the TSA there. And us going there, at least we put a halt to it for now.
It was as if you had lifted up a rock. You know, and there were a bunch of cockroaches under there, and they just scatter. This is just like scatter, because they had nothing. They said, no, that didn't happen. We didn't have a press release.
And those cockroaches are planning a lot of things.
Can we do this again? they tried to cancel the meeting.
Yeah.
So can we do this another time when all the doors are locked? Or, you know, I mean, it's they're not even good at this. You know, they're getting all this money from the federal government. And it's pouring down from the federal government and into all these programs within these large cities, and it's spreading across the United States, and they're handing the operation over to somebody like Sheila Jackson Lee, and she doesn't even know how to get away with this.
Sheila Jackson Lee is not a friend of freedom or the people of the city of Houston. We've seen her numerous times stand up for the status quo. You can find articles on Infowars and on HoustonFreethinkers.com of her saying, if we were to remove the TSA, when David Simpson's bill last year in Texas was gonna remove the TSA out of airports, you know, if his bill had passed, the bill that we all know the federal government put a stop to, if that bill had passed, Bus Safe would be illegal. They would not be allowed to put TSA agents on bus transportation. And most likely that's why there was so much resistance, is because they were aware they were gonna roll this program out. And Sheila Jackson Lee was there at that time to stand up and say, if we put an end to the TSA, we're gonna see a new 9/11 attack. So, you know, standing up for the TSA, standing up for the status quo, standing up for these crazy TSA cops running around wearing their badges, pretending to be authority figures, asking people questions and groping them, and most people submit.
Yeah, and it's great that you had a victory, and it was so literally just scared the pants off of these people and TSA. They probably like that. But, you know, it's a huge problem. The TSA agents are now being used to literally occupy America with an expansion of 9,000-plus checkpoints. 9,000-plus checkpoints to check me to make sure I'm not a terrorist in America, the land of the free, home of the brave, and these are already operational last year, 9,000-plus checkpoints, already operational. 12 more TSA Viper teams, visible intermodal prevention and response, will be added to the 25 who are already present at transportation hubs throughout the country. And then they have checkpoints in Tennessee where they're stopping people randomly on the highway.
Amtrak stations in Florida. They're spreading.
In your memory, where was the last place you saw all this going on? It sure sounds a lot like...
I think that most of us know, and there's still some people who say that it's an extreme term to compare our times to Nazi Germany, Nazi Germany, 1936. But I think it suits perfectly well when you put it in the context of all the technology we have with drones and... the arrests before NATO, TSA on highways, TSA on Amtrak stations and bus stations. I mean, these things are only going to continue if people don't push back against them. And like the little thing you can do, waking up early, going to one of these meetings and just saying what what's coming from your heart, telling these people that you don't want to be groped, you don't want your children to grow up in this kind of world. And even that little bit of resistance can slow the machine down.
Yeah, from all walks of life too, because I think people are starting to get the message, even if you didn't get it here at Infowars.com, that this is incredibly serious. If you have children or grandchildren, or even if you have grandparents, we're all gonna have to live in this thing, you know, as it increases over the next, it's gonna be pretty soon, next 5 years, things are, every time I come into work, the speed at which they're moving is increasing. We can't even keep up with all these news reports. And for folks out there that think that, you know, 10 years ago, it may have been a conspiracy theory to think about these things, but all you gotta do is go look at the news. Even the mainstream news covers it, although they spin it and say it's for our own our own good. But any closing thoughts regarding what you hope to see in the future in Houston as far as the TSA and keeping them out, or is there any indication that the mayor, Sheila Jackson Lee, that she's going to have another round of grope maneuvers?
Well, as far as final thoughts on this situation, the last thing we told the board members of the Metro is we were able to directly address Chief Victor Rodriguez and ask questions to him. He did the same thing, like you said, little kids casting off the blame in this direction or that direction. Nobody is responsible, the same way every bureaucracy works. We let them know if we hear of the TSA coming back or if there's any other meetings planned with the TSA, we want to be there. And as soon as we find out the TSA is coming back, we'll be right there at the next Metro Board meeting. I mean, we're going to do everything we can. In Houston, our group is banned from both airports for going to the airports and passing out information about the TSA there. We've been detained by them, harassed, and followed all the way out to the airports where they've taken our license plates and things like that. So we're not welcome in the airports, but we still try to talk about the TSA and make people aware of it. And now they've given us a new target. We're not banned from the bus stations. So if they come back to our city, the Houston Freethinkers, we are changed. And I know plenty of other activists and lawyers who are going to be ready to fight them. And we're in it for the long haul, because like you said, if 10 years ago you told people there's going to be drones flying over the skies, you're going to get groped and touched every time you want to fly or take a bus, you know, all these different things, I don't know if anybody would have believed it. You know, maybe those who'd been paying attention, but somebody who was just in the mainstream, it seems unfathomable. Now you look around and it's
completely conditioned. It's just been unyielding conditioning, and it just seems completely normal. You know, you talk to anybody about it, and they've got an opinion. You got no opinion on it. You've got no opinion on it. There's no opinion. Our founders fought for this country. We are the leading, we're the shining city on the hill. We're the only sanity on this planet. We're supposed to lead everyone out of this communist manifesto. Well, thanks for joining us.
Appreciate you having me on.
Derrick Broze, who is... let me ask you before we go. The story about the Korean veteran.
Oh, yeah.
Korean War veteran.
There was one guy who chose to speak at the Metro board meeting. He came up there, he was maybe in his 40s or 50s. He basically said he had spoke with his father that morning and shown his father the videos of the TSA out there and saying, yeah, they're groping people at the airports and now the buses now. This gentleman came up there and said, my father lived through World War II, he lived through the Depression, he lived through the Dust Bowl, he lived through the Korean War and all these tumultuous, intense times. But when he saw the video of the TSA groping people and searching people on the buses, he said he's never been more scared for his life, for this country, than any other time in his life. And he asked this guy, just please go there and just say something. Just say something for me. Tell them that your elders, the people who fought for this country, are afraid of what's coming.
Yeah, it's amazing. Because, he wouldn't put his life on the line in countries where that was happening, where that oppression was happening. And to all these years after that, to come back and see it happen in your own country, it's very surreal that it's happening in America. It really is. It really is. And we got to put a stop to it. And we think Derrick Broze and the Houston Freethinkers, and of course, We Are Change Houston, and You can find his show on freedomizerradio.com and also locallivehouston.com. Thanks again for coming out.
I appreciate you having me on.
Absolutely. Thanks. That's going to do it for our show tonight, folks. Again, to support us, we are completely supported by our subscribers at prisonplanet.tv. You can get a 15-day free trial subscription and check out what we're doing. And we will see you again tomorrow, right here, same time. Thanks again, and freedom and liberty must be retained. Take care.